Welcome back, everyone. This is Dr. O, and this is our last video of the infratemporal fossa. Here we're going to talk through the innervation of the tongue. Now, this is something you've been introduced to and heard about in the oral cavity as well, but we're going to focus in on those nerves that course through the infratemporal fossa to then innervate the tongue. So specifically, what nerve fibers relay taste or special sensory and then general sensory information from the tongue to the brain? So when we think about the tongue, we want to divide it into two distinct parts. The anterior two-thirds and then the posterior one-third. In terms of the division line, rather than being this terminal sulcus that we can see here, it's actually these valate papilla. So these large circumvallate or valate papilla are the boundary between the anterior and posterior parts of the tongue. So anterior to these papilla, we see that the general sensory is coming through the lingual nerve or through V3. Posterior to that line and including the valate papilla, general sensory information will go through glossopharyngeal nerve. Now there is also some innervation from vagus nerve as it is going to innervate the area of the larynx. We see this structure right here is the epiglottis. So that overlap will happen kind of at the root of the tongue most posteriorly. We'll also see overlap from vagus nerve. In terms of special sensory or special afferent taste, anterior to the valate papilla, these will be through chorda tympani. So chorda tympani is a branch off of facial nerve, which hitchhikes or follows the pathway of lingual nerve to the tongue. So posterior to those valate papilla and including them will, for special sensation or taste, will be the glossopharyngeal nerve. So posterior one-third, all glossopharyngeal nerve. We'll see some overlap from vagus. And then the anterior, it's all carried through V3, but remember that taste will be carried back with facial nerve through chorda tympani. So in terms of the infratemporal fossa, here we see the lingual nerve joined by the chorda tympani to carry back sensation, both general and taste, from the anterior two-thirds of the tongue. And then in this image, we're able to find lingual running here, and we can follow chorda tympani as it passes in the infratemporal fossa to reach lingual nerve. Let's take a look at how these nerves reach the tongue. So within the video, we'll find that V3 with chorda tympani is in green, and glossopharyngeal in yellow, and then vagus nerve in orange. And we see V3 more anteriorly represented here. We also see where 9 and 10 come out of the jugular foramen together, and how that branch of vagus is really supplying the larynx, but can send some fibers up to the posterior aspect of the tongue. All right, so let's test ourselves. So which nerve carries taste information to the brain from the area of the valate papillae? So is it the lingual nerve from V3, chorda tympani from facial nerve, the glossopharyngeal nerve, or superior laryngeal nerve from vagus? Take a moment to choose your answer. And when you're ready, the correct answer here is the glossopharyngeal nerve. Well, remember that these valley papillae are the boundary between the anterior two-thirds and the posterior one-third of the tongue. So taste information is carried by both glossopharyngeal nerve as well as chorda tympani. Chorda tympani is the anterior two-thirds, and glossopharyngeal is that posterior one-third. Lingual nerve will carry general sensation from which part of the tongue? So that will also be from the anterior 2/3. And we'll remember general sensation from the posterior 1/3 will also go with glossopharyngeal nerve. And finally, superior laryngeal nerve will be more so overlap in that posterior 1/3 of the general sensation back here. Thank you so much for joining me on these. As always, please feel free to reach out with any questions you may have. Have a wonderful rest of your day, and we'll see you in the next session.